In the era of court ballets, 17th century, both male and female dancers wore heeled shoes according to the aesthetics of the time. However, around 1730, Marie Camargo from the Paris Opera was the first to abandon heels and instead wore flexible shoes, paving the way for the flexible ballet shoes used today. These flexible shoes allowed her to perform jumps and allegro combinations that were impossible to do in heeled shoes, thus expanding the range of movements available to ballerinas. At the end of the 18th century, Charles Didlot, a ballet dancer at the Paris Opera who became a choreographer, invented a wire machine that allowed for flight above the stage. The device lifted the ballerina on her toes before helping her float from one side to the other. The ballet Zephyr and Flora thus introduced the idea of weightlessness. Choreographically, Didlot created the image of what dancing on pointe would mean. In 1823, the Italian dancer Amalia Brugnoli rose on pointe for the first time in front of an audience in the ballet, The Fairy and the Knight, choreographed by Armand Vestris. Brugnoli wore satin dance shoes with a slightly flattened tip sewn on top and had to use her arms in a visible effort to rise on her toes. Nevertheless, she inspired other dancers of the era to attempt the same feat, including Marie Taglioni. In 1832, Marie Taglioni danced an entire ballet on pointe during the premiere of La Sylphide, choreographed by her father Filippo Taglioni. Although she is credited with inventing this type of footwear, for her, dancing on pointe was merely a stunt that added personality and emotion to her performance. Her satin pointe shoes covered her foot, were more durable, had leather soles, and were tied with ribbons. Other Romantic-era ballerinas, particularly Fanny Elssler, who excelled in allegro, perfected the technique of dancing on pointe in the years that followed. Later on, Italian shoemakers created pointe shoes with the toe reinforced with pieces of newspaper, flour paste, and cardboard. The sole had a layer of leather inside. Italian ballerinas could thus execute more difficult steps on pointe, including moments of balance and multiple pirouettes. Some traveled to Russia, where ballet was extremely popular at the imperial court, influencing Marius Petipa to introduce pointe shoes in his ballets. Petipa used them to define certain characters, such as Princess Aurora in Sleeping Beauty, whose prolonged balances demonstrated the dancer's technical mastery. At the beginning of the 20th century, prima ballerina Anna Pavlova, who had thin ankles and highly arched coup de pied, added an extra layer of leather inside her pointe shoes and reinforced the toe box even further to support her body weight. In 1910, when she and her private company traveled to the United States, Pavlova wore pointe shoes made by Salvatore Capizio, the cobbler of the Metropolitan Opera in New York, thus launching the first international brand. Although Pavlova brought pointe shoes into the modern era, her shoes still had a rounded toe box and were very low cut, making them much more unstable than today's shoes. Old footage shows her somewhat wobbling on pointe when dancing in her shoes. Throughout the 19th century, the main purpose of dancing on pointe was to serve the story, making a distinction between ordinary mortals and fairies or other supernatural beings. But in the 20th century, especially with the emergence of Diaghilev's ballets Russes and later George Balanchine, there was an interest in expanding the vocabulary of ballet. Innovative choreographers, from Bronislava Nijinska to William Forsythe, expanded the physical limitations of ballet technique, which required stronger and more durable pointe shoes. This led to the creation of pointe shoes with a flat tip and a solid toe box that we know today, intended to provide increased control. Did you learn anything new from this video? If so, and you want to discover more uncovered facts from around the world, please like, subscribe, and leave comments about what other subjects you would like to learn more about.